Hi there. How are you doing today? Good. Very nice to meet you. Welcome to ASMR Wix. So, I think that you're coming in today to have a wig styling, is that right? Great, okay. So, what is it exactly that you're looking for today? Oh, I see. Okay, so you make YouTube videos, right? I thought your face looked familiar. Okay, so, basically, what we're gonna do today is I'm gonna be taking your wig and placing it on our very lovely mannequin, Sheila. I'll be doing the styling for you today. Great, okay. So have you brought your wig with you? Okay, great. You just popped it over on the counter. Okay, great. And is it still got the lace front? Good, okay. Yeah, it makes it a lot easier when our customers leave the lace front on the wig so that we can pin it easier and then style it. And then once you place it, then you can cut around to get your desired hairline. Okay, great. So let me just pop over and get your wig and then we'll get started. So this is your wig, is that correct? Great. So we've got the kind of dusty rose gold kind of pink. Lovely. Okay. So we'll just take it out of the bag first and we'll have a look at it. Take the tag off for you. There you are. Okay, so if we take this out of the netting and I'll pop your netting down on the floor beside me, and when you go to take it, we'll wrap it up nicely for you again. Okay. So, have you had this wig out of the package already? You have, okay. So, we're going to have to give it a little bit of a brush before styling. Just pop it on. Okay, so it's a very beautiful wig here. Beautifully coloured. There's a lot of dynamic in here, a lot of different tones. So we've got some more peachy tones and then more pink purple tones as well, if you really have a good closer look. Very, very beautiful. Where did you get this wig? I see. Is it quite affordable? Lovely. Lovely. And I must say, for that price, you really have got a lovely deal. The lace front in particular is quite well done. The way that it's misplaced, especially along the sides here as well. Very nice. Well, I'll leave the lace front up to you. We won't be removing that today. But I'll just now pin the the wig down, and then I'll show you the different tools that we've got today to style the wig. Okay, so I've got my little pot of pins here. Okay, I'm just going to start the lace front down. Don't need too many, just enough to keep it secure. Cool. What am I like? Clumsy. There we go. This part can be quite fiddly. So what is it that you do on YouTube? Ah, ASMR. Interesting. I just watched the Super Bowl last night and there was an ASMR advertisement, wasn't there? It's interesting. Yeah, I do. I watch it myself. It's been around for quite a while, hasn't it? Yeah. I know that recently it's kind of been in the media quite a lot, but they call it a fad, which is really strange because it's been around for, what, 10 years now? So I wouldn't call that much of a fad, would you? Sorry, Sheila. I'm sure this must be hurting quite a lot. She's not a big fan of having pins in her head, but pain is beauty. Just fine. Just press them all in a little now. Just so I don't get the hairbrush caught. There we are. Okay, so let me show you what we've got. Now, unfortunately, with this wig, it's quite thick and luxurious at the front. But I do see the back is quite sparing on hair, particularly in the crown area. But luckily, with the way that we're going to style it today, we should eliminate that problem. Okay, so the different tools that I've got to style your wig today. So, first of all, of course, we have a hairbrush, and this is just a plastic tooth hairbrush, quite a firm brush, just to help to brush the hair up. A little comb so that I can easily separate the hair if needs be, like so. Drawstring back for half hair ties. We've got lots of different colours for different shades of hair. Most probably use blonde for for this particular wick. Then we also have the little hair grips. So one for brunette and one for blonde. So these are the ones that we're probably going to use today. Then we also have some hairspray. Now these types of wigs can be washed, which is why we are able to use the hairspray, but on synthetic wigs that can't handle heat or product, then hairspray of course would not be an option. Okay, and always with hairspray, less is more, so we won't be using too much of it. Okay. Then finally I have my hairdresser's scissors. Now, are you thinking of trimming it at all today? Well, it is rather long. I would imagine that this would probably come down to around your waist area, looking at how tall you are. So, if I were you, I definitely would consider maybe taking off about 6 inches of it. It seems to go quite struggly at the ends. It's really lovely and thick at the top, and then as you kind of maybe get past this point, this kind of goes off. And of course, if you were wearing it as a ponytail, the wig would look quite lovely with the pointed curled end. But as you're planning on something different, I wouldn't suggest that personally. Also, the back does actually expose when the hair is fully lifted, so I would be on the cautious side of wearing this hairdo completely up. I would always have at least a half up, half down option. Okay, right. So let me just quickly show you. Got my hair scissors. Right here. Are you thinking of having the trim? Great, okay. So, that's everything that I currently have to show you. So, we shall begin by first brushing the hair. So when you have the wig out of the packaging, did you wear it out at all? You did? Okay, I can just tell because it's a little bit knotty. Not to worry, it's perfectly okay. This is where I'm talking about the ends looking quite faint, like so. I like to brush the hair in sections just so we can make sure that it's all lovely and smooth. Okay. So there we are for that first section. So what I'm going to do now is I'm just going to place a hair bubble around the hair just to separate it. Wigs are a lot thicker than human hair, so means that it can be quite difficult to brush, so sectioning is definitely a must. Going to do is undo this bubble and brush both these sections together. So much hair can make it almost instantly knot itself. Okay. So I'll tie that piece up again. back section here. Be taking a separate bubble. Okay, and then brushing the final front section here. The back side bubble out. Just brush those two sections together. Okay. Finally, moving this. Just give me one final brush here. Already. Looking so much more lovely. Okay. Okay, just moved her around a little bit so that you can now see the length. So, what length specifically are you looking for today? So currently we're coming all the way down to here, so we've got around 22 inches. Now what I would suggest is you go around to here. So we're taking about 6 inches off the length. Mm-hmm. And also by doing this, it will completely neaten up the actual wig itself. It will give it a clean line, meaning that when you curl and style it, it will create a much nicer bounce at the bottom of the hair. Yes, great, okay. So, if you don't mind, I'll begin cutting the hair. Great. Okay. can get. If I remove just some of the strands, so you can get an idea. We're not going to this length here. Yes, great. Okay, so we'll continue. Makes it very difficult when the hair is so thick. As you can imagine, I have quite a whale of a job here doing wigs on the daily, but having carpet rather than hard flooring, the mess management is exciting to say the least. The only difficulty with the hair being so thick is sometimes you do get left with a few pieces, but there we are. Let me show you so far. So we've just got a really lovely, clean line, like so. Okay. Moving on, so you can see the difference in length. Yes. I can't tell you enough already how lovely this is going to look. There are just some pieces that just for some reason they get caught. Very relaxing experience, isn't it? Watching it at work. One thing about styling wigs, it is quite tedious when you want to change the length, but I promise you it'll be very worthwhile. And also, usually when you give your wig a haircut, it ends up looking a lot more natural, so definitely worth giving it a go at least.
the head around a little now. Just for easier access. Doesn't it look a lovely length?
It's almost just below shoulder length.
You can see here that the wig cap is exposed quite a lot, so we do have to be careful with the back side of the wig. Of the hair that I've already cut so that I can compare lengths. And I always take a piece of the hair that I've already cut so that I can compare lengths. It does make it more difficult being left-handed, of course, but not to worry. I am going to leave you to style it with heat on your own, purely for the reason that once I have finished it, before you come to wear the actual hair, it is going to lose the curl. So you're best actually curling the ends on your own, but you can do the rest. And I'm not going to create any layers in the hair, just because layers are quite dated now, actually. You don't tend to see a lot of people with layered hair anymore, so. Looking lovely. Getting there now. definitely tell the difference, can't you? I just think that the shorter length and the blunt ends makes it look a lot higher quality as well. Okay, moving on. Okay, and last section. These small strands that we have left. I think we're done there. Great, okay, so yeah, now we have your new lovely length. I'll show you from the front. What do you think? Okay, so we'll just turn you back round and we'll start styling.
Okay, so now that we have cut the hair to a shorter length, I'm just going to put my scissors away and then we'll start discussing the styling. What are we thinking? Right. Okay. Oh, that's lovely. Okay, so we're going for kind of space buns. Yeah, great. Okay. That's no problem. All right, so are you wanting a centre parting as it is now?
Yeah.
Okay, great. So, if I just turn this way slightly. So, let's leave a small section for you to curl, if you please. Like so. As I said before, the back is rather sparingly, so we're going to leave this section out and just work from here. So, I'm just going to brush this piece out. We're going to create a slight twist. Again, making sure it's all very smooth. Okay, I'm taking a thinner bobble and sectioning that piece off. So now we have this here. Okay. Great. And now moving on to the other side. Again, we'll brush it out. So, see that that piece is even.
Need a little bit less. There we are.
Okay. So again, we'll just section off here.
Stay it slightly. Making sure that it's even.
Okay. Then taking another small bubble.
So there we are. Let me just have a quick look, just so that I can see that we are all even. Just needing to tighten this side up slightly. And of course, we don't want it to be completely perfect, because of course, when we style our own hair, it's never completely symmetrical and identical. So, those two pieces, and I think we're now ready to start making the space buns. Alright. Turning back around, I'm going to just give it one quick brush again. First, take the hairspray and I'm going to spray the front section. Now what we're going to do is we're going to take the little ponytails and take the comb, and I'm just going to slightly tease this hair now. Just so we've got a little bit of texture. Yeah, that's all we need. Okay. So, now what we're gonna do is we take the hair, just going to slightly brush so that we get a smooth bun. Taking this, I'm going to start to roll the hair from underneath. So, and then they're going to be pinned like such. Just get a tighter roll on that using my fingers.
So we first want to take our pins and start to pin from the back. As we move around. Like so, pin as we go. With little moments like this where it comes apart, but we just fix that easily with another pin. There we are, and then we're going to have another one just here. So, I'm just going to take the hairspray to spray that secure. And then finally the last space bun. Okay, so again we'll take the comb just to use the hair. Smoothing the top. And then starting to roll again. Okay.
poster.
The other space bun. So I'll just take the hairspray and just fix that in place. Chopped rose gold wig. Which you can now pop heat into, I would suggest a really bouncy curl with this look. And then we also have the teeny little accents here, which will just come just in front of your ears, that you can also curl. And then of course we have our lovely little space buns. Now they do look slightly skew if that way, but that's just because we need to yank the wig this way a little, and the parting is naturally slightly this way, but when you wear it, it will look more natural that way. Okay, no problem at all. I hope that you've really enjoyed watching me through this process today, and I hope that if you have another wig that you'd like me to style at some point, then you'll come back and see me. No problem. Thank you so much for coming in today. Okay, so we'll get this bagged up and I'll send you on your way.